So when you design a Kalman filter, you need effectively two things. For the state, you need a state transition function, and that's usually a matrix. So we are now in the world of linear algebra. And for the measurements, you need a measurement function. So let me give you those for our example of the 1D motion of an object. We know that the new location is the old location plus velocity. Turn this into this matrix, you have a 1 over here and a 1 over here. The new velocity should just be the old velocity, because it's 0 over here and a 1 over here. If you multiply this matrix with this vector, this is exactly what you're getting. And for the measurement, we only observe the first component, the place, not the velocity. And that uses a vector or a matrix like this. So this matrix will be called F and this H. The actual update equations for a Kalman filter are involved. And I give them to you, but please don't memorize them, and I won't prove them for you. Even the proof is very involved. Every time I use them, I just look them up. There's a prediction step where I take my best estimate x, multiply it with the state transition matrix, matrix F, and I add whatever motion I know, u. That gives me my new x. I also have a covariance that characterizes my uncertainty, and that is updated as follows, where t is the transpose. There's also a measurement update step, where we use the measurement z. We compare the measurement with our prediction, where h is the measurement function that maps the state to measurements. We call this the error. The error is mapped into a matrix S, which is obtained by projecting the system uncertainty into the measurement space using the measurement function projection, plus a matrix R that characterizes the measurement noise. This is then mapped into a variable called K, which is often called the Kalman gain, where we invert the matrix S. And then finally, we actually update our estimate and our uncertainty using what ought to be the most cryptic equation that you've seen in a long time. Now, I wrote this down so that you have a complete definition, but this is something you should not memorize. If you really wish to understand this math, it happens to be just the generalization of the math I gave you to higher dimensional spaces, but I would recommend just not to worry about this. There's a set of linear algebra equations that implement the Kalman filter in higher dimensions.